So let us see the last question from this paper. So question number 11. Here is first one from progressions. A man starts repaying a loan as a first installment of 1000 if he is increasing the installment by 500 every month. So what amount will he pay in the 38th installment? Okay, first installment is 1000. Every installment is increasing 500. So this is the A value and this is the difference. So 38th installment, that means A30 we need to find out. So it's a simple question. We take this first one given data. So according to the question, man is start repaying the loan of first installment is 1000. So this is in arithmetic progression. So A is equals to rupees 1000 and is increasing every month. There is a common difference, rupees 500, right? These are the two data. And 38th term of AP, because 38th installment you need to find out. So therefore, 38th term of the AP is A30. That is equals to A plus 30 minus 1 into D. Because you know the formula, AN is equals to, AN is equals to A plus N minus 1 into D, right? So this formula will apply in this. And A30 we need to find out. A plus, so 1000 plus 30 minus 1, 29. Difference is 500. We can simplify this. 1000 plus 29 into 500. So 1000 plus 29 into 500 is, that is 14,500. 14,500 plus 1000 is 15,500 is the total. Therefore, amount that he will pay in the 38th installment is rupees 15,500. Right? Simple question. And see the next one in this paper. A takes 9 days more than B to do a certain work. And together they can do the work in 6 days. How many days will A alone take to do the work? Right? A takes 9 days more than B to do certain work. This is the condition. So let B take X days to complete the work alone. Take first. So let B take X days. This is not given. So let us B take X days to complete the work alone. So A alone he can complete in X days. And as per the question, A takes X plus 9 because it takes 9 days more. According to question, A takes 9 days more than B. So therefore, as per question, A takes 9 days more means X plus 9 days to complete the work alone for him. These two. Now together they can do in 6 days. Okay. Current question. Together they can do in 6 days. How many days will A alone take to do the work? We need to find out. That means B alone we should find out first. Then only A will come by adding that number. And they together can do in 6 days. So there is a given. Therefore, given is together. They can do in 6 days, right? In 6 days, they can do together. Then we can write this statement like this. One is x, one is x plus 9. So 1 by x plus 1 by x plus 9 is equals to 1 by 6. Because they, B can do work in x days. So in 1 day, he can do 1 by x, the part. X plus 9 is A can take. So 1 by x plus 9 is 1 day's capacity, that is equals to 1 by 6. Then just if we simplify, we'll get the value of x from this symbol. Taking cross mod LCM, x plus 9 plus x by x into x plus 9 is equals to 1 by 6. And by solving this all, 2x plus 9 by x squared plus 9x is equals to 1 by 6. Do cross multiplication, and simplify equation, it will come like this. X square minus 3x minus 54 is equal to 0. Cross multiplication and simplify. We factorize this quadratic equation. So x square minus 9x plus 6x minus 54 is equal to 0. If you add or subtract, middle term should get. And take x common, x minus 9 plus 6 common, x minus 9 is equal to 0. X minus 9 into x plus 6 is equal to 0. So one is negative value, one is positive value. So x is equals to minus 6 or x is equals to 9. So this one will take because this is a neglected. Because there is no negative value, x is equals to 9. If x is 9, then a alone we can complete. Therefore, it is asking only a alone can complete the work. So you complete the work in x plus 9 days, that is 9 plus 9, so 18 days. So 18 days alone, A alone can complete the work, right? Now see next one. So last question in this paper 11c, a sphere is placed in an inverted hollow conical vessel of the base radius is 5 cm and vertical height is 12 cm. If the highest point of the sphere is at the level of the base of the cone, find the radius of the sphere and ratio of the volume of the sphere and to the cone. That means sphere is placed in an inverted hollow conical vessel, the base radius is 5 cm. So let me draw the diagram, this is a clear understanding for you. To take the cone and sphere is inside. We take a vertical cone. Conical shape. So in this cone and sphere is placed. Sphere is a circular shape. We should take this spherical shape inside. Center to 1 which is the radius. And according to question, base radius is 5 cm and vertical height is 12. This is 5 cm from here to here and vertical height is 12 cm. Radius and height, if you know, you can find out the slant height. This is simple. So R be the radius of the sphere. So first we'll take the cone. In this radius is equals to 5 cm. And height is 12 cm. So slant height is L, that is square root of R square plus H square. So square root of 5 square plus 12 square, square root of 25 plus 144 is 169, that is the 13 cm. So 13 cm is the slant height. So using similarly, you will get R by 5, so it's a radius. And from this total, this part you subtract. So if it is, this also radius one. Straight height. From here it is both. So this also radius from here to here and this also radius. Now using similarity. So when you take the similarity property for this, so similarity property you need to apply here now. So you should use the similarity concept. So I will draw a diagram here to understand clearly. For example, in triangle, so this is the height and one more is given. Okay, so this is the phi and this is r. This is totally 12. And this part is 12 minus r. 12 minus r is this. And this is the 13 is total. So by taking corresponding ratios in similar, so using similarity properties, from this we will get r by 5 is equals to 12 minus r by this total is 13. From this 13 r is equals to 12 minus r into 5, that is 60 minus 5 r. Then from this r is equals to 6 by, take this side, 13 r plus 5 r, so 18 r. That is 60 by 18, so 10 by 3 centimeters. So r is the 10 by 3 centimeters now. So radius of the sphere, because radius of the sphere only are taken r. So first one is radius of the sphere. We got that is 10 by 3 centimeters. We write an extraction 3 1 by 3 centimeters, right? And now you can take the ratio of the volumes. So volume of the sphere by volume of the cone. We need the second question is ratio they asked. So volume of sphere by volume of cone. These two. So volume of the sphere formula 4 by 3 pi. R cube. R is 10 by 3 cube. So volume of the cone is 1 by 3. Volume of the cone. 1 by 3 we can take by RH. That is 5. 1 by 3 pi R square H. So 5 square into height is 12. Cancel this 5 pi both sides. 3 cancel. The remaining is 4 into 10 cube, 100 into 10 by, for cancellations you can write like this, 27 into 25 into 12. By cancellation we will get 40 by 81. That's it. Therefore, so according to the question, the ratio of, just only take the calculations properly, you get answer easily. So volume of the sphere to the cone. Sphere to the cone is 40 is to 81. So this is the ratio. Right? So by making similarity concept only, you can find out like these problems. That's the main thing. And you can solve this problem. Now this is about the paper. What are paper 5? And more papers are available in this same website as I explained starting. You can see. And see the link in description below also, and especially this channel for students on link to the education. So subscribe the channel and share it with your friends. So thank you very much for watching.